So in this video we are going to discuss the new chapter, force and friction. So in force and friction you will study force, a push or a pull, effects of force, type of forces, friction, advantages and disadvantages of friction, and the fluid friction also. Here the activity is given. A man is, see the pictures, the man is pushing the car, a boy is flying a kite, and a drawer is pulled to open it. So these are the action, that means pushing and pulling. So in some cases either push, or in another cases either the pull takes place, but there are the various cases in which both push and pull can take place. For example, flying a kite. In flying a kite we not only pull the kite but also we push the kite. So both pushing and pulling can say that force is applied. So force is called as a push or a pull. This, when you look around in your surroundings, you will see a number of things which you will push or with your push and pull. So this push and pull action applied on an object is called force. So now come to the next page. So force is applied in every actions, either when we open or shut a door, when we lift a book or any heavy objects, even the football players kicking a ball, batsman hitting a ball, we stretch an elastic rubber when a wet clothes. So all these actions involve forces in the form of push or pull, stretching and lifting. So we can say that to move an object or to stop the motion of an object, it has to be either push or pull. So we can define force as a push or pull. So underline this line, force as a push or pull. So the direction of application of force is determined by the direction of push or pull. Now come to the topic, effect of forces. So forces causes all types of motion. So what do you observe in the following pictures? Some pictures are shown here, a man pushing the lawn mover to move it from rest. Even a golfer is hitting a ball which was at rest. So as soon as the force was applied on the lawn mover as well as to the golf ball or in any object at rest, it starts to move when a force is applied on it. So this is the first effects. So we can conclude that a force applied on an object at rest set it into motion. In simple words, a force can move a stationary object. So underline this line, force can move a stationary object. This is the first effect that we are discussing. Next, when a cyclist applies more forces and pedals hard, the speed of the brake increases. Again, if someone is pushing the cycle from behind the cycle, the speed of the cycle increases. If, on the other hand, if your friend or anyone pull you from the back while cycling by applying force from the in the opposite direction, then the speed will slow down. So we conclude that force applied on a moving object can change its direction speed. It increases the speed when applied in the same direction of motion, whereas it decreases the speed of the object when applied opposite in direction of the motion. Underline this line, the speed of the object can be increased when applied in the direction, and it can be decreased when applied in the opposite direction. So this is the second effects. Now, a football player kicks the football and changes its direction. Similarly, a batsman hit the ball, moving ball, with his bat and changes its direction. So the force from moving wind changes the direction of the kite flying up in the sky. So thus, from all these examples, we conclude that force applied on a moving body changes its direction of motion. So this is the third effects when a force is applied to a moving object. Now come to the next page. Some pictures are given below. A baker is applying some force with his hand to change the shape of dough into different shape. Even when we blow air into a balloon, the shape of balloon changes. And also when we stretch a spring, so we conclude that force can change the shape and size of an object. underline this line. This is the fourth effect. So to summarize, is we conclude that force can, number one, move a stationary body, number two, stop a moving body, number three, speed up or slow down a moving body, number three, change the direction of motion, and number five, change the shape and size of a body. So underline this, all this line. Body stops a moving body, speed up or slow down, change the direction and change the speed and size of the body. These are the effects of force. So you will write this effect of force in your science rough copy. So this will be the homework for you. Learn and read the pages also. That's all.